One of the glories of Los Angeles is its modernist residential architecture. But Hollywood movies have almost systematically denigrated this heritage by casting many of these houses as the residences of movie villains. It begins with A Damn Don't Cry in 1950. Frank Sinatra's Palm Springs Retreat, designed by Stuart Williams, plays the home of a local gangster boss. Then in 1955, a band of psycho kidnappers led by John Cassavetes holds up in a prototypically mid-century modern house in the Hollywood Hills. And there has usually been something sinister about the Innes House. Its most frequent role is the mansion of some gangster chieftain, often a representative of the Yellow Peril.
There's been a problem.
The most celebrated episode in Hollywood's war against modern architecture is L.A. Confidential. Richard Neutra's Lovell House, the first great manifestation of the international style in Southern California, plays the home of Pierce Patchett, pornographer, pimp, prince of the Shadow City, where whatever you desire is for sale. Actually, director Curtis Hanson greatly admires the Lovell House. He even gives it a special credit at the end of the film, according to the honorific title favored by its original owner, the Lovell Health House. Is it just a convention then? The architectural trophy house is the modern equivalent of the black hat or the mustache? It's nothing to take seriously. Well, the architecture critic of the Los Angeles Times took it seriously. He cited L.A. Confidential as some kind of proof that the utopian aspirations of modernist architecture were bogus. He wrote, "The house's slick, meticulous form seemed the perfect frame for that kind of power. Neutra's glass walls open up to expose the dark side of our lives. They suggest the erotic, the broken, the psychologically impure." So now we know. As the movies have shown, these pure modern machines for better living were dens of vice. In fact, this fiction is contradicted not only by the original spirit of the Lovell House, but by its entire history. It was designed as a kind of manifesto for natural living, and it became a center for radical left-wing political meetings in the 30s.
Wow, man, you got everything.
There is one modernist architect Hollywood lets off lightly, Pierre Koenig. Perhaps it's because he had a knack for turning steel and glass cubes into Hollywood Regency-style mini-mansions. His stall house is an icon of modern architecture, and lately, a movie star. In The Marrying Man, it plays the Hollywood pied-à-terre of a multimillionaire playboy, although the film is set 12 years before it was built. In The First Power, it plays the home of a police psychic. And in Why Do Fools Fall in Love, it is the West Coast base of Zola Taylor, the female vocalist in The Platters. We feel bad when Frankie Lyman trashes it. On the other hand, the architect Hollywood most loves to hate is John Lautner. In Twilight, a Lautner house overlooking the San Fernando Valley is a crooked cop's reward for his corruption.
Nice place you got here. Sure beats Los Feliz. You're up above the smog.
It's quite a pad you got here, man.
A more elaborate Lautner house in the hills of Beverly plays the Malibu beach house of porn king Jackie Treehorn in The Big Lebowski.
How's the smut business, Jackie?
I wouldn't know, dude.
I deal in publishing.
Lautner's most famous house is the chemosphere, a hexagon of wood, steel, and glass raised above its hillside lot on a single concrete column. It appears in body double as the bachelor pad of a lunatic driller killer. Lautner's interiors may be sometimes vulgar or excessively ostentatious, but he can't be blamed for this one, a bit of excessive art direction designed to parody 80s excesses.
Hollywood.
Yeah, too Hollywood.
The ultimate insult to Lautner's work came in Lethal Weapon 2. The Garcia House on Mulholland is the home office of a drug ring organized by the South African consulate. Enraged by their diplomatic immunity, Mel Gibson pulls down their house with his pickup truck. Not only is Lautner slick and superficial, he's incompetent. Lethal Weapon 2 is also the work of a modern architecture fan. Producer Joel Silver is famous for his tasteful restoration of a Frank Lloyd Wright house in Hollywood and a Wright-designed plantation in South Carolina. Even though Lautner was Wright's disciple, Hollywood's conventional ideology once again trumped personal conviction.